I'm Zephyr Hensley, and we are from Green Mountain High School. We decided to build a National Institute of American Technology. So for our site selection, we really were deciding between the Stapleton and the city site. The Stapleton site had open space and a view, so we had more flexibility. We have a bigger building. But we ultimately decided on the city site just because of more visitors, the pre-existing utilities, and transportation such as bus routes and bike lanes. And we decided not even to consider the C470 and Alameda site because we're from right down the street there and we like our open space. We don't want it developed.
All right, our design criteria. The two-story museum with under 50,000 square feet and costing less than $15 million. We decided to use half of the city block to construct on in order to use, to optimize our space the best, and while still including enough area for parking.
Our design process began when we made a bubble diagram of our entire layout with each building. After that, we calculated the square footage of each different room and then put it all together for our final design. Some of the main features of our design include IMAX, solar panels, a green roof, and a lot of open space and exhibits. Like I said, some of our major features include IMAX, we also have a water feature. We like to showcase our renewable resources, and also there's going to be retail.
Alright, here's our Google SketchUp. We have solar panels, as you can see, on the north side, as well as our green roof. We also have an open patio above our first floor, and we have a glass-covered atrium to let in our light. Here's our first floor design. We have our parking lot. We didn't focus too much on that because there's the parking around because it's the city location. We have our large IMAX theater, our atrium, our entryway. We have a large glass facade there. And our gallery starts off as a boat. Walk in like you're walking off of a boat, arriving in America, and as you go through the exhibits, it's like as technology advances in America. So it's really focusing on just the advances in technology. And our gallery space slopes up from our first floor all the way to our second floor as it goes around, and then returns back to our specialty gallery, which changes as time goes on because we decided to make that our future design area so we can change out what technology is coming in the future.
So here's our structural plans. We decided to use steel braced frames on drilled piers. The braces on the frames provide resistance to different types of loads such as wind and earth movement. And our base floor system is a composite concrete deck on steel beams. And this is our structural plan for our second floor and roof. As you can see, our atrium and our event space are both two stories high. And for our roof, we use the same flooring system to accommodate for the load of the green roof.
All right, we decided to use neutral colors and a large area to create an inviting atmosphere in our atrium. And we also decided to put a large water feature.
Our roof features several technological advances. We have a green roof to help reduce the heat island effect, and then we also have half of it being solar panels to help power our museum and give back energy for it.
So here's our LEED scorecard. We got 77 points, which means we are LEED Gold certified. And some of the points we got were public transportation access and scenic daylight views.
This is our cost estimate for our museum. We total around $11.8 million, which is about $4 million underneath the max. Some of our features are on here, including the IMAX screen, also the solar panels, and the wind turbine.
here's our schedule for construction. We found out it would take about 60 months to complete everything from site layout and foundations to putting in the last solar panels, electricity, and fire systems.
We just want to say thank you for watching our presentation, and also thanks to all of our ACE mentors for helping us through the process.